Louisiana is already unique with our political boundaries. For example, we have parishes, not counties. And here in Acadiana, we have something even more rare.
Well, we're probably the only parish in the state that is not contiguous. We have a portion of our parish by which you have to traverse two other parishes to get to if you're coming from the main part of St. Martin Parish.
Now, it's simple enough to get your way into St. Martin Parish, but it's not very often that you come in through St. Mary Parish. Yeah, you need to go all the way to Morgan City to get back into Lower St. Martin Parish. That's over 60 miles from St. Martinville, the home of St. Martin Parish's government. It's home to Stevensville and Bell River. Both communities obviously love the water. Well, most of the time. And taking a drive down LA 70 and LA 997 along the levee is gorgeous. Most of the time, you have the road all to yourself. But what happened, and why is it still like this? And after a few more miles on a very lonely LA 997, you end up back in Iberia Parish. This is the part that cut St. Martin in half.
It's my understanding that in the mid-1800s, 1840, 1850, somewhere in that area, the legislature created Iberia Parish, and in creating Iberia Parish, there was some sort of, so the books tell us, surveying era that ended up segregating St. Martin Parish into two areas, you know.
And that can bring other challenges for Iberia Parish. This part of the panhandle is over 70 miles from New Iberia, where the parish government is centered. And as parish president, does he feel he's been cheated out of some territory?
No, I feel for the residents in that area sometimes. I know they feel as though they don't get their fair share. I understand that. It's very, very unique. And, you know, I just invite people to go take a ride and just ride around the Highway 70 corridor between St. Mary Parish and Assumption Parish down Highway 70, which is St. Martin Parish.
And when you head back, you don't necessarily have to turn around. The drive-through Bayou Pigeon takes you along the Port Allen Lock, so be prepared to get stopped at a drawbridge or two, and then go all the way back north to Gros Tete back to I-10. A lovely drive through the lesser-known path of the Atchafalaya Basin. For Acadiana's News Channel, I'm Dave Baker.